Tonight, Travis Vader's father and stepmother speak out for the very first time publicly.
In an interview with our David Ewasuk, they send a message to the McCann family, assess the work the RCMP have done, and give a very frank portrayal of the man suspected in the disappearance of Lyle and Marie McCann.
We don't want the McCanns to think that we are making light of this, because it is a very, very serious.
We're ignoring their situation.
I mean it's the most horrible situation you can be in.
When Travis Vader's parents agreed to speak with CTV News, among their reasons, a chance to tell the McCann family that they too hope the missing couple is found soon.
We fully support them in the efforts they have.
My light is going on my porch every night. Every night.
But they want the public to know that when investigators put out Travis Vader's picture nearly 2 weeks after St. Albert couple Lyle and Marie McCann were last seen, they were stunned.
When we heard that Travis was named
person of interest,
that just floored us at that point. We just feel that the whole thing has been horribly bungled, and we're getting painted with a dirty end of the brush, and we're not that happy about it.
Ed Vader pulls no punches about how his son's life has unraveled. The father says the son went from earning tens of thousands of dollars a month as a drilling consultant, from being able to financially care for his seven children, to someone facing criminal charges.
Yeah, he did get family support. He just didn't accept it. He wanted family support on his own terms. And that doesn't help. It's like giving an alcoholic one more drink just so he doesn't shake so bad.
Ed Vader says his son has a short fuse and can be, at times, physically intimidating. Travis Vader is well known to local police.
RCMP now confirmed that in their efforts to locate the missing couple, Travis Vader became a person of interest early on. They now say that his photo was released to the public only after their efforts to locate him were unsuccessful.
Ed Vader wonders what role, if any, the RCMP delay in responding to the couple's disappearance played in his son quickly becoming the focus.
I believe that Travis was an easy pick from that day. They had blundered and had a problem. He was on their radar. He was somebody that had a charge that could be brought up.
The parents claim RCMP were actively looking for Travis even before the McCanns went missing, and that they were trying to help find him.
He was.
I mean, he was on a bicycle, he was on a trike, he was on a quad, he was driving vehicles. You know, people seeing him.
And after the McCanns disappeared, Jennifer Vader says it certainly didn't appear that Travis was fleeing very far or very well.
They've got film of him that Tuesday before he was arrested. And if they're really doing their jobs, they could have had him right then and there. It was like 10 o'clock at night.
The video she speaks of, obtained independently by CTV, shows Travis Vader buying beer, speaking to a customer, staying only more than a minute on July 13th. It's just before 11 p.m. The RCMP say they tried to bring him into custody before his picture was released days later. They will not say if he was already a subject of interest when he appeared at this business.
We made efforts to locate them. Obviously, for us to come forward and to name him as a subject of interest, to put out the posters, we could not locate him at that time.
The RCMP stated that when they arrested Vader in an early morning operation not far from his parents' home, he was a person they believed had information regarding the disappearance of the McCanns. That changed at the end of August.
He is our primary suspect because the investigation leads us to believe that he is involved in some way in the disappearance of the McCanns, of Lyle and Marie.
His parents say they've spoken with Travis while he's been remanded on unrelated charges. They say he's denied any involvement in the disappearance of the McCanns.
And when we say that if he's done anything wrong, he's going to do the time, we mean it. There ain't no joke about that.
Over and over, he has said he had nothing to do with the disappearance of those two. And I know he had. I know he didn't. I just, in my heart, no.
On special assignment, David Ewasuk, CTV News.
And if you have any information about the disappearance of Lyle and Marie McCann, you can call any RCMP detachment or Crime Stoppers. There is a $60,000 reward for any information that helps find them.